हेलो क्लास नाइन्थ, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द रिमेनिंग कॉजेज ऑफ द राइज ऑफ असर्टिव रेडिकल नेशनलिज्म विच इज़ अ पार्ट ऑफ लेसन फोर पेज नंबर 106. मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव्स: इंटरनेशनल इवेंट्स, इफेक्ट्स ऑफ द रेवोल्यूशनरी प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ द वेस्ट, पार्टीशन ऑफ बंगाल, कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ बाल लाल पाल. बिफोर द डिस्कशन ऑफ टॉपिक वी मस्ट नो द फॉलोइंग टर्म्स. मिथ: अ ट्रेडिशनल स्टोरी based on supernatural beings or events, explored, shattered violently. Superiority: a state of being superior in rank, status or quality. Revolution: revolution means sudden change in political power. Intensify: becomes more intense, showing feeling or opinion strongly. Democracy: government of the people, for the people, by the people. Fraternity: feeling of brotherhood. Liberty: liberty is a state of being free. Equality: equality is a state of being equal, especially in status, rights or opportunities. Communism: principle of political organization based on federal communes. Enlightened: showing a rational, modern and well-informed outlook. Swaraj: self-rule or self-governance. Hesitation: the action of pausing before saying or doing something. Now let's discuss the international events. Assertive nationalism was inspired by the examples of the international events. For the first time, Japan, an Asian country, defeated Russia. On the other hand, the Italian forces were defeated by Ethiopia. Ethiopia is a country of Africa which was underdeveloped country, and on the other hand Italy was a developed country. Both these events exploded the myth of the invincibility. Invincibility mean quality of being powerful of the Europeans. Moreover, they were also inspired by the revolutions of Russia, Egypt, China, France, Ireland, Turkey. These events inspired by the assertive nationalists to intensify their struggle against British rule. Now we will discuss about these revolutions. Russian Revolution took place in 1917. Cause for the Russian Revolution was economically widespread inflation. Inflation means continuous rise in prices and food shortage. China Revolution 1912 caused decline of king state. Egypt Revolution 1914 caused Egypt was controlled by the British without real and legal authority. French Revolution 1789 causes expenses of king and queen, poor harvest, high bread prices, financial crisis. Revolution of Ireland 1912 caused continuing resistance of the major IRA leaders. IRA means individual retirement accounts. Revolution of Turkey 1919 caused upper class wanted to overthrow the autocratic sultan. Autocratic means dictator. Now let's come to the reading part. International events. Japan made great progress in the industrial and military fields. Industrial field, that where the goods are manufactured. Military field, and the defeated Russia in 1904 and 5, as we have discussed. Italy was also defeated by Ethiopia. Ethiopia is an African country which was underdeveloped country, and he defeated the one developed country. Both these events exploded the myth of European superiority and encouraged the Indians. They felt that European nation could be defeated. It was possible for the Indians to drive away the English from India. They were also inspired by the revolutions in Russia, France, Egypt, Ireland, Turkey, China. As we have discussed, these international events inspired this section of the nationalists to intensify the struggle against the English. All these events inspired the Indians to take action against British. Effects of the revolutionary principles of the West. As we know, educated Indians were not given high post. This treatment added to the bitterness for the British rule. They were lowly paid. Many of them were unemployed. Unemployment is a state when the people are not engaged in economic activities. But the spread of Western education inspired the educated Indians with the Western ideas of democracy, nationalism, liberty, equality, fraternity. Democracy means government of the people, for the people, by the people. Nationalism means love for your own country. Liberty means state of freedom. Equality, state of being equal. Fraternity, feeling of brotherhood. They believed that freedom can be achieved by these revolutions, means not through the constitutional methods. They felt that the self-government was necessary for political, economic and cultural development. They became the sworn enemies of the British imperialism, means when the strong country ruling over weak country. Now let's come to the reading part. Effect of the revolutionary principles of the West. The treatment given to the educated Indians by the British rulers added to the bitterness. They were lowly paid, means they were not given the high payments. Many of them were unemployed. Unemployed means it is a state when the persons are not involved in the economic activities. They were declared not fit for the appointments to the high post of the responsibility. But the spread of the Western education inspired the educated Indians with the Western ideas of democracy, means government of the people, for the people, by the people. Nationalism means love for your own country. Liberty means state of freedom, equality, state of being equal, and fraternity, feeling of brotherhood. They felt the foreign domination very strongly and realized that freedom can be achieved through revolutionary means and not through the constitutional methods as adopted by the early nationalists. They felt that self-government was necessary for the political, economic, and cultural development of the country. They became sworn enemies of the British imperialism, means they did not like the British imperialism, they were against the British imperialism. Partition of Bengal. The situation became highly explosive. Explosive means they shattered violently. When the Lord Curzon announces the partition of Bengal in 1905, the reason cited by him for this decision was efficiency in the administration. The actual intention was to divide the Hindus and the Muslim nationalists. The decision resulted in the widespread protests and agitations. The people protested and launched the Swadeshi and boycott movements. Use of goods. Swadeshi means use of goods which are made in your own country. Boycott means say no to the foreign goods. All these protests were put down with the severe repressive methods, means the restraining personal freedom. This act gave a crushing blow to the national unity. The partition hurt the sentiments of the people and led to the widespread of agitations. Now let's come to the reading part. Partition of Bengal. The situation became highly explosive when the Lord Curzon announces the partition of Bengal in 1905. It added fuel to the fire. He declared that aim of the partition was to introduce efficiency in the administration to the big province like the Bengal. But the reality was that he wanted to sow the seeds of communism and drive a wedge between the Hindus and Muslims. They wanted to create a rift between Hindus and Muslims and give a crushing blow to the national unity of India and rising the nationalism by adopting the policy of divide and rule. Divide and rule, it is a strategy of dividing the communities like Hindus and Muslims into two different groups. The partition hurt the national sentiments of the people and led to the widespread agitation. Agitation means protest, and not only Bengal but also the other parts of India. The people raised the cries of Vande Mataram and launched the Swadeshi and boycott movement. Swadeshi, as I told you, use the goods which are made in your own country. Boycott means say no to the foreign goods. And very important saying is said for the partition of Bengal by S.N. Banerjee that let's discuss. The partition announcement fell like a bombshell. We felt that we had been insulted, humiliated, and tricked. Contribution of Lal Bal Pal. The most important leaders who contributed to the rise of assertive radical nationalism, they were Bal Gangadhar Tilak, Lala Lajpat Rai, Bipin Chandra Pal. They opposed the constitutional methods which were adopted by the early nationalists. They advocated agitations and vigorous political actions to Swaraj. Swaraj means self-rule. They laid great emphasis on self-respect, self-reliance, self-sacrifice. They taught the people to rely on their own efforts. Moreover, Lala Lajpat Rai and Bipin Chandra Pal also advocated the need of agitation, means protest, by advising the people to rely on their character, self-sacrifice, and their efforts. Now let's come to the reading part. Contribution of Bal Lal Pal. Enlightened leaderships of Bal Gangadhar Tilak. Enlightened means those who are having the rational outlook. Tilak, Lala Lajpat Rai and Bipin Chandra Pal were the most important factor which contributed to the rise of assertive radical nationalism. Nationalism means love for your own country. They opposed the constitutional methods of early nationalists, means the methods which were against the violence. They were opposed by the assertive nationalists and advocated the agitation and vigorous political actions to achieve Swaraj. Swaraj means self-rule. They laid great emphasis on the self-respect, self-reliance, and self-sacrifice. They taught the people to rely on their own efforts, means they must believe on themselves. Once he wrote in the Kesari, if thieves enter our home and we are not having the sufficient strength to driven them out, we should without hesitation shut them up and burn them alive. You must have understood this thing. Lala Lajpat Rai and Bipin Chandra Pal also advocated the need of agitation, means protest, by advising the people to rely on their character, self-sacrifice, and their own efforts. And most important saying for the contribution by Tilak for the Swaraj is that Swaraj is my birthright and I shall have it. It is said by Bal Gangadhar Tilak. Means Swaraj is a fundamental right and everyone must have this right. Children, today we will discuss till here. You will have to reread point number 7, 8, 9 and 10. And kindly follow your SNAP homework and learn the related question answers. Thank you.